Blackstone presents Into the Inferno, A Photographer's Journey Through California's Megafires and Fallout by Stuart Palley. This book is read by Stuart Palley. Preface. Powerhouse Fire, May 31st, 2013, 4 p.m. A wall of fire careened toward me from a few hundred yards away. I lay on the hot asphalt, catching my breath and regaining my bearings. The scream of a fire engine rolling down the road jolted me upright. There was white-hot pain in my ankle as I hobbled along to the roadside shoulder. The fire jumped the road behind me, and the winds blew a bellowing column of smoke directly between me and my car. My escape route was cut off, and for all I knew, my fancy Land Rover, parked in the dirt next to the unburned fuels, was also on fire. I was moving slowly after running back to my car in surplus combat boots that were two sizes too big, and I tripped face first again into the asphalt. I was greeted with a mouthful of the Los Angeles County Department of Public Works' finest handiwork. Standing up, I resolved to run through the dark, horizontal column of smoke leaning over the two-lane road, determined to make it back to my car. I had to start work at a newspaper the next morning and couldn't let my car catch on fire. I had no fire shelter and no radio or way to call for help. I took a deep breath like I was preparing to blow out a birthday cake and made a hobbled dash through the smoke. Immediately, ash particles made my eyes sting and squint nearly shut. The smoke in my lungs caused my asthmatic respiratory system to convulse and protest with hacking coughs. The hangover from the photo festival the night before was running strong, and the single-digit humidity and 90-degree Mojave Desert heat didn't help. I kept moving forward into the suspended reality, using the edge of the road as my guide to keep moving in a straight line through the smoke as visibility was reduced to zero. Was this it? Would I trip again or pass out and get run over by a fire engine as smoke turned day into night? My mother would kill me even though I'd already be dead. After what seemed like an eternity but was really only seconds, I emerged on the other side of the smoke to a Los Angeles County Sheriff's deputy parked near my car. He was supervising an emergency roadblock. A dozen civilians looked on at the fire, filming on their iPhones. A large Type 1 heavy helicopter dropping hundreds of gallons of water hovered overhead, the rotor wash blowing my hair. The sheriff held back TV news cameras and a line of frustrated commuters. The ad hoc crowd looked at me quizzically, silent, as if I were a flaming rabbit running out of sagebrush. The sheriff's deputy leaned on the wide-open driver's side door of his Crown Vic, looking out toward the fire, transfixed and clutching his mobile radio mic. I was covered in ash, dust, and sweat, had a twisted ankle and a broken zoom lens, and had barely made it out of the way of the flaming front of the powerhouse fire. My heart was still racing as I fumbled for my keys and the push-button ignition with my adrenaline-impaired fine motor skills. I was scared and beginning to realize the gravity of the situation as helicopter turbines roared above and sirens drove by. The distance running through the smoke was maybe 50 feet, but had felt like a mile. A strange mixture of pain, excitement, fear, and naivety coalesced into a mildly perverse smile. Physically intact, but dignity shattered, I laughed as my ankle began to swell. I liked this. Introduction. California, Spring 2021. Into the Inferno is my story of 8 years photographing and witnessing fire. Those first hours at the Powerhouse Fire were a chaotic preview of what lay ahead. Over many summers and falls, triumphs and tragedies, I grew as a wildfire photographer. A young man grew into an adult and saw what he thought was drought become the product of full-blown climate change, human development, and decades of fire suppression. Throughout Into the Inferno, I'll try and show how fire shaped me and how the flames literally tempered my character along the way. Through my near-decade-long dance with fire, I'll cover some of California's largest, most destructive, and deadliest fires, which I captured from the front lines between 2012 and 2020. I remember the terrifying scenes at the 2017 Wine Country fire siege, the Thomas fire just months after, and the terror on the beach in Malibu at the Woolsey fire. As I write this introduction on the precipice of yet another fire season, the forecasts say we're in for a brutal summer and fall, and new fires are already actively burning. There's still snow on the same mountains where fire is consuming the trees, and all of this is largely unprecedented. At these fires, I witnessed first responders and civilians alike engaging in heroic acts to save lives and property. From one job to the next, I saw wildland firefighters risk their lives and mental health to keep people out of harm's way while trying to save homes. These memories are difficult to share, but they have value because they demonstrate the acute and current effects of climate change in California. These stories also highlight the effects of human encroachment on the wild.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.